New at 4 last week, Suncor announced that one of its three plants at the refinery in Commerce City should be back up and running and hopefully going to bring down gas prices along with it. Here to talk about Colorado's overall look for gas prices ahead of a busy President's Day weekend, AAA's Skyler McKinley. Skyler, good to see you. Thanks for being here. All right, I hate to ask this because I know the answer that they're high, but how high are gas prices here in Colorado right now?
I spend a higher than usual amount of time thinking about gas prices, and even I'm surprised. Right now, the statewide average is around $4.10. That's up 80 cents on the month. It is 80 cents higher than it was last year when they were historically high. It is up $1.20 from January. It is 70 cents more than the national average. Colorado has the fastest increase in gas prices in the country, and we have been in the top 10 most expensive markets for gas really almost every week in 2023. So it is not just you. Everybody's noticing these high prices right now.
You're the bearer of great news today talking about this. So how much is Suncor affecting the gas prices? And when this one plant comes back online, how much should that affect them the other way to make them go down?
Yeah, prices are rising everywhere right now. There's just stronger than expected global demand. Supply is still a little tight. The Chinese economy is opening back up. So this has put upward pressure across the country. Prices are increasing so much more quickly and dramatically in Colorado, though, almost entirely because of Suncor. That is why we are so much higher than the national average. That's why we're increasing so quickly. Suncor coming back online will stabilize prices. It means that we won't see the 10 to 20 cent jumps we've seen week over week. That's going to make a difference, but I don't think prices are going to fall off a cliff. I think by the time everything's up and running, prices will be rising nationally anyway. We're going to be carried along in that tide, and so Colorado's average might fall in line with the national average, but it certainly won't drop to where it was pre-Suncor shutdown.
That's not good news.
No.
Especially with summer coming up. That's going to increase prices as well, right? More people drive, you get the summer blend. When does all that start?
We can expect summer blend switchovers happening probably March into April into May. That adds 15 cents on top. We have spring break travel. That's going to see spikes in March. And then we get in the warmer months when everybody's driving. Here's what I would say, though. High gas prices are usually a signal of a strong economy. So if the bottom falls out of gas prices, it's a signal of something really, really bad like we saw when COVID first happened. So at least, I mean, that's the only bright side to what we're paying right now.
That is good. You talk about the so-called recession, this shows maybe not going to happen.
Right.
All right, Skyler, thank you.
Thanks.
Appreciate it. Talia.